Good morning children. Today we will discuss about the properties of rational numbers. So first let me revise you what are called rational numbers. Rational numbers means they can be written, the numbers which can be written in the form of P by Q are called as rational numbers. Now these rational numbers will possess some properties. Let us check whether that properties are applicable in all the binomial operations or not. So first let me check the first property, which is closure property. Closure property, we will check this closure property, is it applicable in the set of rational numbers in all the four binomial operations or not. The four binomial operations are basically the binomial operations are addition, subtraction, multiplication and division are called as binomial operations. Let us check this closure property is applicable in the set of rational numbers under addition, subtraction, multiplication and division separately. If they are same, that we can say that it is a property that is satisfied in it, otherwise it is not. So let us say, what is closure property? Already you have learnt in your 7th class. If A and B are two rational numbers, the sum of them is also a rational number, then it is called as the addition is closed under subaddition. Addition is closed in the set of rational numbers. Means what? Now let us take an example. Let A is equal to something like 1 by 2 and B is equal to minus 3 by 4. And let us find out the sum of them. A is a rational number, B is another rational number. We are finding out the sum now. 1 by 2 plus minus 3 by 4, we are going to get it as 1 by 2 minus 3 by 4, plus of minus will be minus 3 by 4. Let us take the LCM of it. 1 here we are writing first and read the 2 table, where will you get there for 2? 1 2 is a minus. Read this numerator, write this numerator again, read here 4 table, you are going to get there 1. So 1 into 2 is equal to 2 minus 3 is equal to minus 1 by 4. Means what? It is a rational number. 1 minus 1 by 4 is the number which you got it by subtraction, 2 minus 3 by 4, which is equal to minus 1 by 4. Now minus 1 by 4 is also a rational number. Is it rational? Yes. So it is also a rational number. Means what? We have taken A as rational number and B as rational number. We found the sum and that sum also we got it as a rational number. So in general we say that rational numbers are closed in addition. We say that rational numbers are closed in addition. Means addition property is applicable in the set of rational numbers. Additional property in the closure property, additional property which is in the closure is applicable in the set of rational numbers. Now the second binomial operation, let again will be taking A is equal to minus 2 by 3 and B is equal to 1 by 4. Let us take those two and now A minus B means we'll find out the difference between them. Difference means here we have to do A minus B. A means what? Minus 2 by 3 minus B means 1 by 4. So LCM of these two is equal to minus 12. And first we write there minus 2. 3 here divisible by 4 times. Minus 1 into 4 is divisible here by 3 times. 4 2 is what? Minus 8 minus 9 by 12, which is equal to minus 17 by 12. If you see, this is also a rational number. Means what? Subtraction is also closed in rational numbers. So in general, we say that subtraction is closed in rational numbers. This is what we can say. Now coming to the next one. What is the next one? Addition is over, subtraction is over. Now find out the product of them. Now we will see the product of them. So let A is equal to something like 5 by 6 and B is equal to minus 1 by 3. Let us find out the product of it. How do you find out the product of it? 5 by 6 into minus 1 by 3, which is equal to minus 5 by 18. For multiplication, you will never take the LCM. only LCM will be taken only in the addition and subtraction. Remaining you have to multiply it. So 1 into minus 1 is 5 into minus 1 is equal to minus 5. 6 into 3 is equal to 18. Now this is also an addition. Sorry, this is also a rational number. Means what? Here subtraction is addition is closed under rational numbers, subtraction is closed under rational numbers, and we got minus 5 by 18, which is also a rational number. Means what? Multiplication is also closed. Multiplication is closed in rational numbers. Multiplication is also closed in rational numbers. Now the fourth binomial operation, which is nothing but a division. By dividing we are going to get a quotient on the division. In by finding out the multiplication we get the product. If we find out this, if we do the subtraction, we are getting differences, and addition obviously you know it is a sum. Now let A is equal to 2 by 3 and B is equal to 1 by 6. Let us find out whether they are closed in division or not. Now let A is equal to something like 2 by 3 and B is equal to 5 by 6. Now let us find out A divided by B. Here it is equal to 2 by 3 divided by 5 by 6. So which is equal to 2 by 3 into, write the reciprocal of it, it is 6 by 5. You can cancel 3 2s, it is equal to 4 by 5. We got a rational number here, but there is one exception to this rule. Suppose A is equal to 2 by 3 and B is equal to 0, because B is also a rational number and 0 is also a rational number, we take it. A divided by B is equal to 2 by 3 into 0 by 1. Sorry, divided by 0 by 1. 2 by 3 into 1 by 0. So this becomes what? Undefined. So what happens? The quotient that you are going to get is not a rational number. In the yesterday's class, I told you, previous class, I told you that 1 by 0 is undefined. So we know where we have to get it 1 by 0, which becomes a rational number. So here, closer property is not, means quotient or division. Division is not closed under subtraction. Any property which should satisfy for all the terms and conditions, then only it becomes a property. Here, whatever may be the B value, whatever may be the A value, it is satisfying, because if you add 0 to it, you are going to get 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is a rational number. If you add or subtract 0 to 0, B becomes 0 or A becomes 0, the difference also you can find out. Now coming to the product, if anything is becoming 0, you are going to get the 0 as your answer, you can find out. But coming to the part of division, it is not possible. Why it is not possible? We have an exception for anything divided by 0 is undefined. So here division is not closed under, is not closed in rational numbers. So what we have understood with this now, addition is closed under subrational in the set of rational numbers. Differences means subtraction is closed in the rational numbers, and product multiplication is also closed in the rational numbers, but division is not closed in the rational numbers. This is one. Now coming to the second one, let us find out the second property. What is the second property? Commutative property. What is that? Commutative property. Commutative property means what? If we change the position of the numbers, will it be having the same value or not? That is what is called as a commutative property. Here we will change only the position of the rational numbers. That shall be, is it satisfied in the set of rational numbers or not in all the four binomial operations is to be checked. Now here we are having, let A is equal to something like 1 by 2 and B is equal to 1 by 4. Now let us find out the A plus B, which is your LHS, and other side we have to do the B plus A. Means we have changed the position of A and B from the left, from the position has been changed of A and B, interchanged. So here we have 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4. Here LCM will be equal to 4. Here 1 into 2, here 2 times divisible, plus 1 into 1 time divisible, which is equal to 2 plus 1 by 4. You are getting 3 by 4. Its value is equal to 3 by 4. Now let us find out the value of B plus A, which is equal to 1 by 4 plus 1 by 2. Now LCM is equal to 4. 1 into 1 plus 1 into 2, here 1 plus 2 by 4, and which is equal to 3 by 4. Here we got 3 by 4 and here also we got 3 by 4. What is the meaning of it? Here, though we have changed the order of those rational numbers, the value, final value does not change. So here we say that commutative property is applicable for, commutative property is applicable in the set of rational numbers. Commutative property under addition is applicable. Addition is applicable. Is applicable in the set of rational numbers. In the set of rational numbers. Now coming to the second one. Here A is equal to 2 by 3. B is equal to 1 by 5. Let us take like this and find out the subtraction. Subtraction means what? Here A minus B we are taking, and here B minus A we are taking. See, here commutative property always says about the position of the numbers, rational numbers. Here A by B means, A minus B means what? Here it is 2 by 3 minus 1 by 5. LCM is equal to 15. 3 here 5 times, 5 into 2 is equal to 10. Minus 5 here 3 times, 3 into 1 is equal to 3. I think you understood this. So 10 minus 3 is equal to 7 by 15. This is your final answer of A minus B. Coming to the part of B minus A, it is 1 by 5 minus 2 by 3. And let us take the LCM here. Now 1 into 5 here, 5 3 times divisible, and 2 here 5 times divisible. It is equal to 3 minus 10 by 15, which is equal to minus 7 by 15. Here, if you find the value of A minus B, you got 7 by 15. Now, if you find out the value of B minus A, you got minus 7 by 15. Are they equal? No. Means what? This commutative property under subtraction is not applicable in the set of rational numbers. Means what? Commutative property is not applicable in the subtraction at all. Here, in general, we can say that commutative property is not applicable, is not applicable in subtraction. Now, what is the next operation? We have the next operation is a multiplication operation. Multiplication operation here, let the third one, let us see the product of it. So let A is equal to 2 by 5 and B is equal to minus 1 by 5, something like this. You take 1 by 6 or something, whatever you want, you can take it. Now A into B is equal to, here A into B and here B into A again. A into B means what? 2 by 5 into minus 1 by 6, which is equal to, you can cancel 2 ones, 2 threes. So 1 into 1 is equal to minus 1. 5 into 3 is equal to 15. It is minus 1 by 15. Now coming to the part of B into A, B means what? Minus 1 by 6 into A is equal to 2 by 5. Here also you can cancel. So this is equal to minus 1 by 15. The final value in the rational numbers in the multiplication A and B or B into A are same. Hence we say that rational numbers means commutative property is applicable in multiplication in the set of rational numbers. So here we write it as commutative.